thank you everyone for making the time. Really excited to talk to you today about our company and our plans for the year ahead. So we are Cashrewards, and we are the market leader in the already significant but fast-growing cashback category. We are a business that is high growth, and that growth is driven by an outstanding product. Customers love great products, and we have one. And whether it be through our app, our website, or our Notify, what we do is provide a really engaging shopping experience with customers able to browse amazing offers from great brands and ultimately the opportunity to shop now and save now. Our product connects brands directly with high-value shoppers in a simple way. I'll touch on these through the presentation, but our market in which we're the leader is already large, it's growing fast, and it's significantly underpenetrated relative to similar geographies. And while we're really excited about the business and what's ahead is, we have, and we'll talk to it more throughout the presentation, a tripling of our active customer base over the next 12 to 18 months through the rollout of Cashrewards Max. We've got a frequency curve that demonstrates a classic network effect, and the average rate that we earn from merchants is going up. And we'll talk through each of those points throughout the presentation. To our ecosystem, as I said, we're the clear Australian market leader in a fast-growing but globally proven cashback category. And what cashback ecosystems do and what we do is connect customers and brands. You can see on this slide that we have more than 1 million members, and what they get is real cash savings when they shop with more than 1,700 of Australia and the world's biggest brands. So today, for example, our members can earn 15% at Apple, 12% at ASOS, 12% at Sephora, 15% at Best and Less, and thousands of other great savings. And that's just a regular Wednesday for us. Our offers are dynamic, so our members can routinely access offers like 8% at Apple, more than 15% at booking.com. And these offers deliver customers real cash savings, and our product makes that easy. We're able to offer members these savings because we deliver our brands on the right-hand side excellent returns on their marketing spend. We take wasted advertising spend on usual things in the marketing world like clicks or eyeballs, and we put that spend directly in the hands of brands shopping customers. To date, our products facilitated more than $2.7 billion of sales for merchants and more than $70 million of savings for our members. We make money by charging a commission on every sale, and we give part of that commission from brands back to our customers in the form of the saving. The brand doesn't pay us a cent unless we deliver a sale, and so zero risk and great returns for brands, and that enables us to deliver exceptional savings for members. Our competitive point of difference is the combination of the quality of our product, which we continue to invest in to maintain market leadership, as well as the critical mass that we've built up across both members and merchants. As an ecosystem, success of any cashback business is dependent upon that combined scale. And absent that scale, it's impossible to provide the value to members and merchants that ultimately provides or powers the growth. And I'll talk to more about the clear trajectory of growth that we have as we continue to attack the underpenetration, as well as the ANZ relationship. If I explain further on the underpenetration across the category in which we exist, and e-commerce is a tailwind. It's a large and fast-growing market, but significantly underpenetrated relative to similar geographies. This is shown at the bottom of the slide, where the cashback category in the United States and the United Kingdom has achieved 5 to 7 times greater penetration of online shoppers than the category in Australia. And the market is continuing to grow there and here, fueled by the accelerated e-commerce growth, where the top shows the tailwinds in Australia from the relative underpenetration of e-commerce. Ultimately, growth is fueled by the product, by the simplicity of savings being irresistible for customers and the marketing returns being compelling for brands. It's a really exciting business model with incredibly strong member economics. And that's illustrated on this slide. Firstly, we're differentiated relative to traditional e-commerce businesses. We're a business that only needs to acquire a member once, and we know that new members increase significantly in their value over time. So members that we've acquired in the recent periods, in the last financial year, they will deliver further revenue growth in this financial year and beyond as they continue to mature. So We already have significant frequency, as you can see on this slide, and we have a long customer lifetime, but it's growing fast. Our numbers demonstrate a classic network effect. Our frequency, as I said, is already significant, but our value increases every year. And over time, that's the result of customers using us more often, more retailers offering more better offers, and ultimately becoming more of a member's shopping habit. At the IPO, which was only executed in December last year, we talked about our focus on increasing these metrics. And you can see on this slide that having set out systematically to improve our product to deliver on this focus, the results speak for themselves. Following the IPO 9 months ago, we've already increased our customer lifetime value by more than $50 to $500 in spite of travel average revenue declining. And we've already increased the lifetime from 5 to 6 years. I talked earlier around how excited we are around the growth that is underpinned by Cashrewards Max. Cashrewards Max is a Cashrewards program made available to ANZ's 4.7 million credit and debit card customers. It was launched less than a month ago. And you can see on this slide that we expect active customers to triple between FY21 and FY23 due to the rollout of Max. In addition, and excitingly, that the significant product and technology investments needed to establish Max also delivered product and technology enhancements that will benefit all of our members and merchants. And this investment will support continued improving member and merchant economics over time. Touching on our performance highlights for FY21, really pleased to say that with a clear strategy, we've delivered strong performance on the metrics that we established through executions of initiatives to drive member growth and member engagement as measured by member activity and frequency. We talk about underlying performance on the left-hand side. That's the performance in our control. It excludes travel, where COVID obviously saw a shutdown of that category and resultantly a revenue decline by 51% in FY21 versus the prior calendar period. With a focus on investment towards continued product enhancements, we've delivered against the strategy of more members shopping more often. You can see in the top left that we grew shopping members by 46%. And as I've mentioned, we talked at the IPO around our focus on frequency, and you can see with clear initiatives that in the bottom left-hand side, we've grown the number of shops a member does with us by 32% to almost 16 in the period. And including travel, our members now shop with us in compelling 17 times a year, which is up 30% on the prior calendar period. It's the focus on the strategy and these results that's delivered the financial highlights that I'll touch on. The slide shows how focus on these strategic metrics has delivered strong financial performance. The top of the page shows all of our key metrics up close to 50% year on year on an underlying basis. And you can see below that there was almost $520 million of sales through our platform in FY21. Growth in our key metrics saw underlying revenue grow by 54%, demonstrating continued momentum as that 54% growth compares to 31% as at the first half. And I'm really pleased with these results in the context of raising in the latter part of the first half of this financial year, and in particular, our strong Q4 performance, which saw us continue to grow significantly on a prior calendar period, which obviously included a step change in growth driven by e-commerce penetration scaling through COVID. You can also see that our focus supported us deepening our merchant relationships or our relationships with brands, ultimately translating to a greater share of marketing budget, which saw absolute sales and commissions increase across all categories, and our reported commission rate shown on the slide increasing from 5.4 to 5.9%. You can see at the bottom of the page, and I'll expand on this shortly, that travel fell from 22% of sales or TTV in FY20 to 9% in FY21, but we still grew total reported revenue by 29%. In this context, we're really excited about the eventual return of the travel category as we benefit from a significantly scaled customer base. And we'll continue to deliver strong performance across all these metrics as we continue to execute against our strategy. I'll pause for a moment to talk to that travel opportunity that I touched on. the focused execution on our strategy has delivered the strong underlying business performance of 54% revenue growth. But obviously, in the context of COVID, our key travel category hasn't followed. Our reported revenue growth of 29% was in the context of a 51% decline in travel revenue as it fell from 21% to 8% of total revenues. This decline saw travel revenue drop by $1.7 million year on year, despite us having increased our active members by almost 40%. And with annual revenue per user falling by $12 to $6, we obviously have the opportunity to capitalize on the return of the travel category with a significantly greater member scale. So we're positioned incredibly well to capitalize on the rebound through the combination of deep relationships with brands and merchants in those categories, but also through that significantly scaled active member base in FY21 and growing into FY22. In terms of FY22, I've talked through this presentation about us being crystal clear on the opportunity and having a focused strategy to ensure our success. You can see through our results that we've been executing against that strategy. We're well on our way to delivering on our scale objectives as we focus on momentum continuing as our new and existing member cohorts mature and our focused investment in our product, improving our member and merchant economics. Our FY22 growth will, as I've shown or mentioned, will be transformed by the significant growth of our active member base through Cashrewards Max throughout FY22, with the member base set to triple as a result of that initiative alone, and more so into FY23 and beyond as new members mature and product benefits are realised. Our strategy hasn't changed. Our strategic priorities remain to grow members, to drive member engagement and to deepen merchant partnerships. And we've got targeted initiatives to continue to drive success against that strategy and continued growth across our key metrics. And this will continue to grow our sustainable competitive advantage. And we see it generating real operating leverage for the business to power medium and long-term returns for shareholders.